Question number one. Next, he says, I have stress in me. Is there a way to cope up with this stress? इस तनाव को कोप अप करने के लिए मेरे पास कोई रास्ता है या नहीं? विल सर्च फॉर एन आंसर. थर्ड, इफ यस, हाउ टू कोप विद इट? जवाब दीजिए मिस्टर मैथ्यू. कैसे हम इस स्ट्रेस का जवाब ढूंढेंगे? नेक्स्ट, विल ऑल्सो गो एंड अंडरस्टैंड, जस्ट क्विकली ब्रश टू दिस सब्जेक्ट, वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस. And we will go into the deeper parts of this subject and understand whether there is a work-life balance concept prevalent. And if yes, is the balance possible? हमारी ज़िंदगी में हम balance ला सकते हैं या नहीं? इसके ऊपर भी हम थोड़ा सा चर्चा करेंगे. This is what I have in store for you in the next 60 minutes. When I tell this word stress, I'm surprised. If I go around 20 years back, when my father used to work in the government organization, I have heard him telling me that I have a lot of tensions. But I don't understand, you know, how come this stress word has come into the society so abruptly? इतने अचानक से सभी लोग बहुत pride के साथ कहते हैं, गर्व के साथ कहते हैं, मुझे बहुत stress है, मेरी ज़िंदगी में बहुत stress है. एक fashion statement हो गया है. अच्छा लगता है हमको बताने के लिए कि मुझ में बहुत स्ट्रेस है. नो वंडर द लेटेस्ट सर्वे डन बाय द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डिपार्टमेंट सेज 67% ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट इंडिया रेट्स स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट एज अ मोस्ट पॉपुलर ट्रेनिंग सेशंस इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. क्या क्या करते हैं? स्ट्रेस ऑडिट, स्ट्रेस टेस्ट, स्ट्रेस सेमिनार्स. Suddenly there is this word stress that has come into our society. And the bad news for each one of you is, it seems that you and I sitting in this particular hall today, we are also gripped by this darkness called stress. Tanav aapke aur mere zindagi mein bhi aaya hai. It has come into the Indian society as well. Unfortunately, a country which offers the world the ultimate lessons of stress is in itself in the dark today. You and I come from a country that has offered the world the most beautiful lessons of managing stress. And that is what I'm going to share with you today. Is there an answer to stress? Before I go into the subject into depth, let me explain you, my dear friends. Listen to this very carefully. Hum stress ko bahut simple way mein samajhne ki koshish karte hain. Dhyan se suniye. There are only two kinds of stress that can happen in your body. One is a physical stress and the other is a mental stress. And these two stresses, they also have two components. Inke bhi do chote chote components hai. One is external and one is internal. Here also there is external and internal. So aapke mind mein ye baat clearly baith chuka hoga ki do hi tarah ke tanav hote hain. Ek physical stress hai aur ek mental stress hai. Physical mein bhi एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड में होता है, इंटरनल वर्ल्ड में होता है. मेंटल में एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड के वजह से होता है और इंटरनल वर्ल्ड के वजह से होता है. लेट मी क्विकली रन थ्रू दिस एंड गिव यू अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ व्हाट दिस डिजीज इज ऑल अबाउट. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट, फिजिकल स्ट्रेस. फिजिकल स्ट्रेस इन द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड, इसके बारे में थोड़ा सा चर्चा करते हैं. फिजिकल स्ट्रेस इन द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड. Friends, let me explain this to you in a very simple terms. What is physical stress in the external world? आपकी जो body है, ये शरीर है, this goes through a physical stress in the external world when you run, when you chase, when you fight, when you defend yourself. When you do these kind of physical activities, the body goes in a state of stress. And this is what I call as physical stress in the external environment. But let me tell you, if you look at your life today, the way man has progressed for thousands of years, the way man has evolved, physical stress has been there for thousands and thousands of years. And that is the reason why your body has an inbuilt mechanism, a beautiful mechanism of a flight and a fight response. जब भी आपके सामने कोई स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन आता है, एग्जाम्पल अ वाइल्ड एनिमल, डेथ कम्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, व्हेन यू आर फेस टू फेस विद डेथ, आपके पास दो ही चारा होता है, या तो उससे लड़ो या यहां से भाग निकलो. बोथ दिस सिचुएशंस योर बॉडी इज केपेबल ऑफ मैनेजिंग. इमीडिएटली बॉडी में कुछ केमिकल्स रिलीज होते हैं. द मोमेंट यू आर फेस टू फेस विद डेथ और एनी इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन, the body releases chemicals, adrenaline, noradrenaline, cortisol, ऐसे कई तरह के chemicals body release करती है. बस मैं biologically आपको समझाना नहीं चाहता, but in brief आपको समझाता हूँ. What does this chemical do? The chemical is released for you to continue survival. The only reason why you and I are walking on this planet, nature wants you to survive. That's the fundamental reason. Survival is very important. इसीलिए survival के लिए it has its own mechanism. तुरंत when you are face to face, when these chemicals are released, what happens in your body? All the blood is directed towards the thighs. The thigh will get more blood circulation. Sudden rush of blood into your brain for critical thinking on the spot. What to do? Whether to fight or to take a flight? Immediately after brain, एक moment के लिए fresh हो जाए. Suddenly, all the things that is not needed for survival will not get any importance from the body. Digestion, कोई जरूरत नहीं है. अब मौत का सामना है, क्या digestion? So digestion will not happen. Growth hormones will not appear. Growth will not happen. Reproduction is not needed now. Survival is most important. Reproduction will not happen. Suddenly, the whole focus comes on running. Suddenly, the body realizes that there is an emergency situation in front, and so the heart starts beating faster. More energy is needed in the system to get rid of this particular situation. And let me tell you the good news. If you all say that I have a lot of stress, you can straight eliminate physical stress from your life. There is no physical stress from the external world in your and my life. We are living such a luxurious life that these kind of incidences are very rarely encountered. And let me tell you one more thing. If it happens, it is good. Your and my body is designed by the ultimate to take care of this situation. So we need not worry. And since you are not doing this, since this mechanism is not running in its perfect design, you have to go for a jog, you have to run on the treadmill, and you have to do all kind of exercises because the body needs this. The physical movement is very much important. Let me take you to the next level, which can be more interesting than what we discussed till now. The second type is the physical stress in the internal world. If you have this question in your mind, let me answer it in the next few minutes. If you look at nature, kudrat ko agar aap bahut kareebi se dekhenge, so there are more than 87 lakh species on this particular planet. You and I are in the topmost layer of these species. And if you look at nature very closely, it is only man who eats even when he is not hungry. You look at the animal kingdom, you look at the plants, the oceans, everything is perfectly, absolutely in their own world. Only man seems to be extremely stressed. Why? Because you are running away from nature. जितना आप कुदरत के करीब आएंगे उतना आपका स्ट्रेस आपके जिंदगी से निकल जाएगा. जितना आप इससे दूर जाएंगे, द मोर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन यू एंड नेचर, प्लीज वेलकम स्ट्रेस इन टू योर लाइफ. सिंपल फॉर्मुला. टुडे देयर इज अ क्लैश ऑफ द ईस्टर्न एंड द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड. देयर इज अ क्लैश बिटवीन आयुर्वेदा एंड एलोपैथी. मोर देन 10,000 ईयर्स बैक, the country that I come from, gifted this Veda to the entire human race, Ayurveda. Ayurveda was thoroughly documented as Maharishi, but as Maharishi Charaka. Charak in his lifetime documented everything that is possible from nature, and he has documented this in a book called as Charak Samhita. It is called as a Bible of Ayurveda. It is referred by doctors across the globe today. Ayurveda talks about coming close to nature. So I'm just sharing few lessons on how to manage the internal world. We are loading our internal system with food and every possible thing that the body is not designed to take care of. How much food should you have? If you read the Yoga Sutras, Patanjali says, Hita, Mita, Ahara, Seva. Patanjali will not talk about controversies. He says, as much as you can, both the hands. जितना आपके इन दोनों हाथ में भरता है इतना ही अन्न आपके शरीर में जाना है, इससे ज्यादा करते हो तो वो आपके शरीर में कई हिस्सों में जाकर बैठ जाएगा. फूड शुड बी इन मॉडरेशन. बट व्हाट डू वी डू? 2 o'clock वी ईट फूड, 4 o'clock वी ईट फूड, 6 o'clock वी ईट फूड, 8 o'clock वी ईट फूड. यू लुक एट द किंगडम्स, एनिमल किंगडम्स, एब्सोल्युटली विद नेचर. What is Ayurveda saying? I'll just quickly explain this to you so that perhaps I'm not telling you these are the do's and don'ts of your life. I'm just suggesting you that if you want to come out of the world of internal stress that your body goes through, then how should you have eating habits? Ayurveda says that you should have 3 meals, 3 separate meals. 2 meals should have a minimum gap of 5 to 5.5 hours. In the morning, when the sun rises, or when you can say that the sun is exactly opposite to your land, let me once again explain this to you. The food that you and I eat does not go to the stomach directly. It goes into a sack, which in Hindi we call as jathar. And in this sack, there is a small fire which is called as Jatharagni. This Jatharagni and the sun has a direct relation with each other. When the sun is rising, the Agni rises. When the sun is setting, the Agni sets. So Ayurveda says that when the sun is rising, when the Jatharagni, modern medical science has also accepted that yes, the food does not go into the stomach, it goes into the sac. We are not aware of this all these years. It is called as epigastrium. So the food first goes into the epigastrium, and there, just like a gas, the flame is there to take care of the food. So morning when you wake up, the flame has just started. Afternoon at around 12 o'clock, 12:30, this flame is ready to go in the reverse direction. The flame is slowly going to go down. आग जो लगी है ये सुबह के वक्त ज्यादा तीव्र होता है, ये धीरे धीरे बढ़ते 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 12:30 के करीब ये रिवर्स पाथ लेने लगता है. 6, 6:30, 6:15, 6:45 जो भी वक्त है हमारे लैंड में, जब सन सेट होता है उस वक्त आपकी जो अग्नि है ये भी धीरे 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 से पहुंच जाता है. इसीलिए यू गो टू द टेक्स्ट इन द आयुर्वेद, they say that you should have a heavy breakfast. Khalo, jitna aapko weight loss. People who want to lose weight, who wants to get out of the world of obesity, follow this for 6 months. Get back to me. Simple formulas from nature. Have as much breakfast as possible. Eat, nothing will happen. Give a gap of around 5 to 5.5 hours. Afternoon, you and I are aware that the sun is going towards its reverse path. The flame is going down and down and down, and therefore he says don't eat much. Subah agar aapne 5 parathe khaye to dopahar ko sirf 3 khaye. Kam kijiye, dhyan dijiye kya ho raha hai udhar. Evening somewhere at around 6 o'clock, 5:45, whatever is the sunset time, that is the last time when you and I can have फूड इनटू दिस एपिगैस्ट्रियम. आग बुझने वाला है. बुझने के पहले भी आग फायर एज अ प्रॉपर्टी दैट विल वंस अगेन टेक इट्स एंटायर शेप एंड देन कम डाउन. घर जाके मोमबत्ती एक बार जलाकर देखिए, आपको फायर की प्रॉपर्टी पता चल जाएगी. इसी तरह आपके भी जो जठर में है वो अग्नि फुल फ्लेम सनसेट के तरफ आएगा. दैट इज अ टाइम व्हेन यू कैन हैव लिटिल मोर फूड बट द बुक सेज नाउ हैव मिनिमम, बहुत कम, ज्यादा नहीं खाइए. अभी ये आग बुझ चुका है, बुझे हुए आग के ऊपर अगर आप खाना डालेंगे तो ये पचेगा नहीं. इट विल नॉट वर्क वेल. देन देयर विल बी इंडाइजेशन, देन देयर विल बी कॉन्स्टिपेशन, देन देयर विल बी गैस्ट्रिक प्रॉब्लम्स. एंड टुडे योर बॉडी कैन मैनेज दिस बिकॉज इट्स अ न्यू बॉडी. Absolutely fit and fine. As in how you progress further, the body will start giving up. It will say, this is not the way. And that is why when the Western world came to this country, they picked up this concept and they said that breakfast like a king, lunch like an ordinary man, and dinner like a beggar. Simple. They put it in English. You have this text in Sanskrit, which you and I do not look at. So fundamentally, Ayurveda says that you should have three separate meals. Modern doctors talk about weight loss. Please take small meals. थोड़ा थोड़ा खाओ, दो दो घंटे में. इसकी after effects मैं आपको बता कर देता हूँ. After validating with lot of doctors across the length and breadth of my country, who knows Ayurveda to the bottommost roots, let me share with this to you. Having food every 2 hours is not good for your body. Why? I'll give you a simple analogy. Samjhata hoon main aapko. Simple. Sadharan words. Or imagine that you are cooking rice. Rice is a common staple. Aap har mein sab hamare desh mein rice banate hain. Aap water ko boil kijiye, uske andar ek muthi chawal dal dijiye. The rice starts cooking. When the rice starts cooking, the moment the water boils, put another fistful, एक और मुट्ठी आप चावल उसमें डाल दीजिए, फिर उसे थोड़ा गर्म होने दीजिए, आग लगी है ना, गर्म होने दीजिए, फिर थोड़ा गर्म होने दीजिए, इसके बाद फिर एक मुट्ठी आप चावल डाल दीजिए, क्या होगा? End of the thing, what will happen when you cook this food? You will have a mixture of rice. नीचे आपको पेस्ट मिलेगा, चिपका हुआ मिलेगा बर्तन. बीच में आपको अनकुक्ड फूड मिलेगा, ऊपर आपको बिल्कुल ही कुक्ड नहीं मिलेगा, सेमी कुक्ड फूड. दिस इज गोइंग टू हैपन इनसाइड योर सिस्टम. हमारा भी तो एक सिस्टम है. देयर इज अ सिस्टम इनसाइड. वन डॉक्टर एक्सप्लेन दिस टू मी सो ब्यूटिफुली. ही सेड, मैथ्यू लिसन टू दिस, व्हाट यू सेइंग इज परफेक्टली राइट, बट आई वांट टू एड वन मोर थिंग टू इट. व्हेनेवर यू आर हैविंग फूड, व्हेनेवर फूड गोज इन टू द स्टमक, बॉडी, as I have once again, I would like to repeat, body only wants to survive. Body doesn't want to become a manager, general manager, senior general manager, vice president. No. Survival is the basic. So the moment you have food, all the food that goes into the stomach calls for blood circulation. So the blood rushes into the system. Where? To the stomach. And that is what is happening to each one of you now. If you are feeling sleepy by any chance, it is absolutely normal. कोई बात नहीं, होना ही आपके साथ. जरे आपके मन के साथ लड़के थोड़ा झटका करके आप उठ सकते हैं. That will be very nice. But it is very natural. What has happened? Food अभी आपने लिया है दोपहर को. तो the moment food goes, body follows its dharma. The dharma of the body digests. Keep ready things को तैयार रखिए. So all the blood has rushed to the stomach. So your brain does not have enough flow of blood. And that's the reason why you might feel like dozing off for a moment. I hope I'm coming clear to all of you. Listen to this very carefully. Now what happens? When you have food at 1 o'clock, suddenly body performs its dharma. It goes and sends all the blood into the system for digestion. And then slowly it sends it to the other parts where it is needed. Your hands, your fingers, your foot, your toe. Everybody needs the blood circulation. And suddenly, again you have started eating. Again the body will follow its karma. All the blood will come here. Slowly and steadily you will realize that the other parts of the body that needs enough amount of blood, the breakdown of the food, calcium, phosphorus, sulfur, minerals, all these breakdowns is going to happen in the further stages. If that is not going to happen, today or tomorrow, organs will start collapsing. So very important, it's a choice you make in your life. Once again, I would like to repeat, it is not a do and a don't. It is what I learned in my life. That although the Western world talks about having small means, it is against nature. The Western world says, morning you should have kakdi and tomatoes and something very light. The Eastern world says, you eat, nothing will happen. The agni has started, the agni will burn it. Evening, after 6 o'clock, don't do that. And let me tell you, you and I are in the generation where we are exactly against nature. I have an 84-year-old father at home. Even today, 6:45, the dinner is over. Absolutely healthy, healthy, fine. Absolutely fine. So these are living proofs for us that they were very close to nature. It is only this generation and the coming, if you and I don't share this with our people, it is this generation who has gone further away, and that is why so many hospitals are on. That is why the hospital industry or the medical industry is booming. It has to. It has to. You're going away from nature. Another one more important thing, internal stress, physical internal stress. I wish to share this with each one of you. People talk with pride that I don't sleep much. Neend mujhe kam hai. 3 ghante sota hu, 4 ghante sota hu, 5 ghante sota hu. Bilkul taiyar rahiye bimariyon ka dher ke sath. Blood pressure, heart disease, cardiac arrest, cancer, diabetes, tayar ho jayenge. If you are not going to have enough sleep, the body will go in a state of stress. No doubt about it. You and I have been here for thousands and thousands of years. And the body is designed to have this kind of rest. Your modern world, your modern society might ask you to, you know, work long hours, sleep less. Ghar jaake bhi kaam kijiye, raat ko 2 baje soiye, 3 baje soiye. But let me share one more lesson that I've learned and then take you to the world of mental stress as well. Sleep is very important. Why sleep is important? Ordinarily, your body should have a minimum of 6 to 7 hours of sleep. If you don't get this sleep, body will go in a state of stress. Organs will go in a state of stress. The medical part, I will try to explain this to you in as easy words as possible. Whenever you sleep, there are two types of sleep. Do tarah ke sleep hai hamari zindagi mein. Ek sleep ko hum kehte hain REM sleep. REM sleep. Rapid eye movement. Aap so rahe hain, but aapke eyeballs jo hain, wo yahan wahan khilta hai. Ye ek tarah ki neend hai. REM sleep. The other kind of sleep that we go through is what is non-REM sleep. Complete silence. Eyeballs bhi nahi hil rahe. Not a single moment here and there. That's the non-REM sleep. And the sleep that you go through at night is a mixture of REM and non-REM. Ye dono hamare neend mein hota hai. Aap jaise hi bed mein jaate hain aur jo pehli neend lagti hai, ye non-REM sleep hota hai. Eyeballs nahi hilte. जैसे जैसे सुबह का वक्त आने लगता है आप REM स्लीप की तरफ चले जाते हैं. इसीलिए मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम द ड्रीम्स कम इन द REM स्लीप. आप देख सकते हैं जो ड्रीम कर रहे हैं उनके जो आईबॉल्स थोड़े ऐसे ऐसे मूव, ये स्विच होता रहता है. थोड़ी देर REM में जाने के बाद फिर बॉडी नॉन REM स्लीप में आती है, फिर बॉडी REM स्लीप में आती है. अर्ली मॉर्निंग योर बॉडी टेंड्स टू कम इन द REM स्लीप. And REM sleep क्या है मैं आपको समझाता हूँ. जब rapid eye movements आपकी body में हो रही है, what does it do? It clears your mind. ये brain के अंदर जो clutter है, आप जानते नहीं, but आपके आँखों से इतनी सारी data जा रही है that you and I don't know. When you walked from that lift till this place, there are several images your eye has caught. You are not aware of it. Images catch kar diya hamare aankhon ne. Is stage ki image capture kiya, Matthew ki image capture kiya. Ye images aapke dimag mein. It goes and rests in the system. There is a clutter with so much of information. This clutter has to be cleared. And when you are in the REM sleep, the clutter is removed. Erase kar dete. Delete maar deti hai file. Non-REM sleep pe kya hota hai? Non-REM sleep is very important as well. The moment the body goes in a complete non-REM sleep, there is a gland called as pituitary gland. Growth hormones chhodti. Aapke sharir mein, I don't know how many of you will accept, at this point of time, millions of cells are dying in your body. And at the same time, millions of cells are being created as well. It's a constant game of life and death. You are dying, you are living. You are dying, you are living. And one day the ultimate happens. So what happens in the non-REM sleep? The growth hormone gets secreted. All the dead cells are pushed away from the body as waste, and new cells are created. And if you don't get this sleep, the body will break down. And there will be increased amount of chemicals in your body. If you go to the doctor, he will say, show me your blood report. He will check a lot of things like CRP, C-reactive protein. The moment sleep is less, C-reactive protein will increase. That leads to all cardiac diseases and arrest. So it is important for me to tell you, if you follow the Western world of staying back long nights, sleeping less, early morning rushing to work, again spending the whole night on work and fun or whatever it is, if you are not going to give your body the designed amount of a minimum of 6 to 7 hours of sleep, be ready for a stress collapse. What happens to people who wake up with an alarm? In the early morning, when you are in the REM sleep, when the rapid eye movements are happening, what happens? Suddenly the alarm wakes you up. And when the cleaning operations were happening, suddenly when you wake up, the whole day your mind is cluttered, you're not fresh. You don't remain fresh. The thinking capability is not at the rest. So two important things when it comes to your internal stress: food habits and sleep. This is very important that we change our lifestyle and get closer to nature. Everything closes its shutter the moment the sun sets. चिड़ियों को देखिए, एनिमल्स को देखिए, अपने अपने घर, अपने अपने, जैसे सूर्यास्त हो चुका है, the game is over. No problems there. The problem is only in the human kingdom. Stress is only here. So the first part of the session was about the physical stress. Two things. One is the external stress. One is internal stress. External stress, we are designed, we can take care of it, but we don't do it. Internal stress, we are not designed for this kind of eating habits. If you read the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna talks about yoga very clearly. He says, yukta ahara vihara seva, yukta cheshtasya karmasya, yukta sopna bodhavasya, yoga bhavati dukha. Simple. He tells Arjuna, you want to know what is yoga? I will start off with you. Yukta, moderation. Apni apni limit. ज्यादा नहीं. युक्त आहार विहार सेवा. आहार मीन्स फूड, विहार मीन्स एक्सरसाइज. अपने अपने. ही इज नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट बॉडी बिल्डिंग, ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट कीपिंग योर बॉडी फिट विद एक्सरसाइजेस. युक्त आहार विहार सेवा, युक्त स्वप्न बोधावस्था. स्वप्न अवस्था स्लीप, बोधावस्था व्हेन यू आर अवेक. इसकी भी एक बैलेंस होनी चाहिए. युक्त कर्मस्य चेष्टस्य, व्हाट डज ही से? कर्म करो, वर्क हार्ड, दैट ऑल्सो इन मॉडरेशन. हर चीज की अपनी मॉडरेशन है. इस मॉडरेशन में अगर आप जिएंगे, ही सेज, आपकी जिंदगी में दुख नहीं हो. यू आर ऑन द पाथ ऑफ योगा. यू डोंट हैव टू डू आसनस, यू डोंट हैव टू डू एनी ऑफ दिस कॉमिकल पोसेस. योगा इज अ वे ऑफ लाइफ. स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग मॉडरेशन. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सिंपल सिंपल स्टेटमेंट्स, दीज आर देयर इन द बुक्स. That is so beautifully documented, but we don't understand. We are in some other world. We want to know what comes from the Western world. We are blind to the abundance of the knowledge that is there. And once again, let me tell you, India is a country which has offered the world the ultimate solutions to stress. Yes, there is an answer to stress. Just read the Bhagavad Gita. Pick up this book called as Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. Only 8 steps. But yes, it is difficult for you and me to practice this. So Patanjali is very strict. He does not document big volumes. 196 statements. Come on, you want to get out of the world of stress? He says, come with me. 8 levels. 8 padav hai. 8th padav pahunchne ke pehle aapke zindagi mein is ye cheez ho gayi hai. And he is very scientific. He is so scientific that thousands of years back, Maharishi Patanjali has documented this book called Yoga Sutras. Even today, you cannot even add one comma to it. The meaning will change. Super, so scientific. It's a science. Yoga does not belong to any religion. It's a science. Fortunately, or unfortunately, you can say, Patanjali was born and brought up in India, so they call it as Hindu. It's not Hindu. Yoga is a science. It's a way of life. And if you can follow this, stress cannot be a part of your life. That's the challenge. Science means yes. If somebody takes a tape from there to here, if it is 25 meters, this guy will also measure it, it will be 25 meters. Patanjali also says, aaj step mere taraf chalo, aapko bhi, inko bhi, sabhi ko iska same asar milega. So this is the beauty of the documentation that is present here.